It's an exciting day. You can't really tell by my face because I'm a little nervous. A year from now, we're going to look back on this day. It's raining on our wedding day, and that's some BS, but it happens. It's a beautiful day, beautiful occasion.
Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this time that friends and relatives can come together before you to witness this marriage. Father, just we want your blessing on this today. This is a sacred time. These vows are sacred. And we not only ask you to bless this time together, that it'll be an honor to you, but that you would bless their marriage, make it long, make it wonderful, make it Christ-centered. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
And you may be seated. And please turn off your phones. Thank you. Eddie and Victoria, when we first met to discuss the wedding plans, I think the first question I asked you was, how did you meet? And when she told me that story, it kind of set the tone for what we're going to do today. And I'd like to share that story because it kind of defines your relationship somewhat. Eddie said, well, I decided to play some hoops and go down to the gym, you know. And so Victoria was at home being kind of bored and studying a lot. She said, I think I'll go down to the gym and play some hoops. And so there they were, and they were on opposite teams. Evan, I don't know the whole story here, but after a while, Eddie got a little irritated with her making so many shots. and so he went off and got his team together and said, hey, listen, when she gets ready to shoot, she has this look on her face. And he described that look. But you never described it to me. What was that? Oh, and biting the tongue. Okay. Concentration. So he ratted her out. I mean, that's how the whole thing started. And so there was some more hoops, you know, and kind of talking a little bit and kind of, you know, getting to like each other a little bit, and phone numbers, and before you know it, there was a lot of time spent together, and kind of changed your life. That was 5 years ago, though. Some of the people here have been saying, you know, it's about time. I don't know. But you take your time. So I was really impressed by the way you've grown together and the way you really are kind of a team. And so after you left the house, after we had our talk, my wife looked at me and said, you know, I got an idea for the theme for what you're going to say. I said, what's that? She said, well, what about Team Robinson? So this is going to be a little bit about Team Robinson today, okay? I think we can make a case from the Bible that God reveals that successful marriage relationships have a lot to do with working together as a team. First, we need to recognize the fact that marriage is God's idea. Sometimes you really wonder when you kind of look around. It's not man's. After creating the heaven and the earth, he created woman, and he created the first marriage team, we'll call it. And after God created Adam, put him in the garden, watched him for a little while, he said, it is not good for man to be alone. And didn't say much more about that, but I know what people are thinking. Yeah, we're kind of lost souls a little bit. And I will make a helpmate suitable for him. And so the team was not complete with man alone. God created Eve to complete the marriage team. And then he said, and this is probably the most important single scripture in the Bible in terms of marriage. It says, for this reason, a man will leave his mother and father and be united to his wife, and they will become one flesh. Now, Jesus quoted this scripture when he was asked by some of the religious leaders of the time about the permanence of marriage. And he said, haven't you read that at the beginning the Creator made them male and female and said, for this reason a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. And then Jesus adds, so they are no longer two but one. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man separate. So God has designed marriage to be a team, a one-flesh relationship. And the term one-flesh denotes not only physical oneness, but spiritual oneness, emotional oneness, just oneness of all kinds. And God has created two uniquely different people to be together. And when they form bring those differing gifts together, they make a great team, just exactly what he wanted, the basic unit of society. So you're well on your way now, and you'll be building a team for quite a while. But just like in sports, just like in basketball, you can call a team, but it's not a team until they become one because they start working together, and that takes a lot of work. Marriage takes a lot of work. Anybody that's been married more than 2 weeks can attest to the fact that it takes a lot of work. In the very beginning of time in my marriage, I've been married 54 years now, but boy, those first years, we were not a team. We had to learn to become a team and become one. And then you get to enjoy the fruits of that as you get a little bit of luck. There's a scripture that I would like to... I like doing a little bit of coaching right now, and there's four principles that I think that really in the Bible that really help make a strong team, and that comes from a passage of Scripture in the New Testament written by the Apostle Paul, and the first principle is to be one, just like we've been talking about. The Bible says, be like-minded, having the same love, being one in spirit and purpose. Work diligently, now these are my words, work diligently towards unity and being one, not be one, but one together. In completing one another, not competing with one another. Work together as a team towards a single purpose. And that's the most important thing, that is the practical scriptures. And the second one is to be selfless. The Bible says, to do nothing from selfishness. Don't merely look out for your own personal interests, but also the interests of others. Now, I think we all kind of have a default towards selfishness, being self-centered, all of us. And so we have to work towards not being selfish, to be looking out for the best of other people. And so my suggestion to you is just always think about what is best for her, what is best for him. How can I encourage, how can I build for us, rather than just looking at my own personal interests. And I do see you already, a little time that I've known you, I've seen you doing that. So just keep doing that. So. And then the third principle is be humble. I think you need to wipe your head two more times. So. And it's hard to be humble when you're great, I know. But, the scripture goes on to say, do nothing from selfishness, selfish ambition, or empty conceit, but in humility consider others as more important than yourselves. So we also have this default towards pride. We have a tendency to consider ourselves a little better, more informed, a little more important, and so we need this large dose of humility in our marriage for a successful team. So my suggestion, listen to one another, learn from one another, value one another's opinions. And the final one, and I think the most important, is it kind of sums up the others, is just serve one another. In basketball terms, focus more on assists than three-pointers. And I had to add that, and I'm going to blame it on March Madness. The Bible says it's all about attitude, and the scripture, again, this passage goes on to say your attitude should be the same as that of Jesus Christ, who being in the very nature of God did not consider equality with God to be grasped, but made himself nothing, taking on the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness, and being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to death, even death on the cross. So Jesus shows us, you know, what all these principles mean. He shows us what real love is. He comes to the earth, he could come as a king, he could set up a kingdom, he came as a servant, he served others, finally giving his life for all of us, so we can have eternal life with him. And so with that, I think if you would follow those four things, King Robinson, be selfless, be humble, serve one another, keep God at the center of your relationship, and I can guarantee you, you will have a great marriage. At this time, they're going to, Eddie and Victoria are going to share their vows with you, some personal vows that they've written. And if I can find them.
You don't know, babe, when you hold me and kiss me slowly, it's the sweetest thing. And it don't change if I had it my way. You would know that you are. You're the coffee that I need in the morning. You're my sunshine when the rain is pouring. Won't you give yourself to me? Give it all. Oh, I just wanna see. I just wanna see. Beautiful you are. You know that I'm singing. I know you're a star. Where you go, I follow. No matter how far. If life is a movie, oh, you're the best part. Oh, you're the best part.
I take you as you are, loving who you are, now and who you are yet to become. I promise to always be your biggest fan and your partner in crime. Together, may we create a household filled with laughter, patience, understanding, and love. I vow to love you faithfully through the difficult and through the easy. And I will always be there for you, right by your side through all the years and all through all that life may bring us.
It's the sunrise and those brown eyes, yeah. You're the one that I desire. When we wake up and know we're in love, it makes me feel so nice. You're the water when I'm stuck in the desert. You're the talent I'm gonna take when my head hurts. You're the sunshine on my life. I just wanna see how beautiful you are. You know that I see it. I know you're a star. Where you go, I follow. No matter how far. If life is a movie, then you're the best part. Oh, you're the best part.
My wife is gentle. My wife is kind. My wife is devoted, loving, true, honest, and sincere. My wife is all those things. And most amazingly, my wife is going to be you. I will stand by you and be a rock for you to lean on. I'll have a shoulder for you to cry on, a pillow to rest your head. As your husband, I am yours. And I tenderly deliver you my heart. You are my light, my inspiration, and I am blessed to be able to call you my ever-loving wife. You are my life, my everything. And I vow to love you truly and deeply and also forever.
If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? Love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? Won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? Love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? Love me, won't you?
Eddie and Victoria will now complete their vows. First you, Eddie. Eddie, do you take Victoria to be your wedded wife, to live together in marriage? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her for better or for worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, and be faithful only to her for as long as you both shall live? Victoria, do you take Eddie to be your wedded husband, to live together in marriage? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor him, keep him for better or for worse, for richer or richer, for richer or poorer? in sickness and in health, and be faithful only to him for as long as you both shall live. Eddie and Victoria will now exchange rings as a sign of their love for one another and their commitment to honor the sacred covenant of marriage. These wedding rings are an unbroken cycle, circle signifying our unfailing love for one another. Eddie, place this ring on Victoria's finger and repeat after me. I, Eddie, give you this ring. As I give you my love and my faithfulness to you forever. Victoria, place this ring on Eddie's finger and repeat after me. I, Victoria, give you this ring. As I give you my love and my faithfulness to you forever. And I would like to seal these vows with another prayer. Father, the marriage relationship is a sacred covenant, as we have seen from the very beginning of time. And you intended to be one person, married to one person for life. And we just would ask that that happen in this relationship. Father, give them a deep, unconditional love for one another. Father, help them to raise their family in you. And just we ask your richest blessing on their lives. Thank you for this time together. Thank you for these families and these friends that have come to honor them and to participate in this. And we just ask that we all pray for them in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Okay. I think we did it all. Shall we go through this again? No. By the authority vested in me as a pastor in the state of California, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. I now present you for the very first time, Team Robinson. Mr. and Mrs. Eddie Robinson.
Let's do it.
Heaven must have made her just for me. When she smiles so warm and tender, a sight for sore eyes to see.
Ooh. Ain't no woman like the one I've got.
Oh, no, man, don't come better.
Make her happy, doesn't take a lot.
She don't ask for things, no damn reason.
So together like a hand in glove,
like pages in a letter.
Ain't no woman like the one I love.
Victoria has been my role model ever since I saw her go out on the court and kill it at basketball, since I saw her graduate from PA school, and now since I've seen her get married to her best friend. Victoria, you have shown me nothing but love, and now, today, on one of the biggest days in your life, I wish you all the love and happiness in the world because you deserve it. I love you. Now let's toast to Victoria.
I'm super happy, as everybody's seen earlier. I cry like a baby, it's okay. Pimps cry. Anyways, I'm very excited and happy for my brother. I cry because it's all happiness and I've seen him grow into the man he is today. And it's you that have made him into the man he is today and have helped him grow into, you know, look at him. Shining though, okay? But I love them and I love her as a sister and her brothers and her mother and everyone. And I'm just so happy that there's so much love in this room today. And I see everybody, oh. But I love you all, and I swear I can't contain my happiness and my tears. But I am, though. All right? I love you guys, and I'm so happy for you guys. And I can't wait to see that baby. Because that's my baby, though. All right, I toast to the happy couple and many years to come. And more babies.
Whole bunch of Evies moving at one time. That or it's me drinking.
So all of the bridesmaids want to say something. So I think April, you're gonna start it off.
Hi everyone, I'm April and Victoria. We just wanted to come up here and I'll say some special words to you and Eddie. You're the most beautiful bride and we're so happy to see you here today. And Eddie, you look good too. I'm so happy you found each other. So Victoria and I have been friends since the fourth grade. She taught me so much through her kindness, standing up for what she believes in, speaking her mind. She always speaks her mind. Victoria, she was also my hero in basketball. I was like scrawny, uncoordinated, I had glasses. And Victoria was Victoria. She was the MVP, she was blocking on these six-footers, blocking everyone breaking legs. And not only that, she taught me how to do a lot in basketball, pump fake, behind the back dribbling. She also taught me to never say that I'm sorry. I'm sure it'll be a lot different at home with you, Eddie. But with that, Eddie, I have some advice for you. I hope that you all would say those three special words to Victoria every day. You are right. And as they say, a man that gives in when he's wrong is a wise man. And a man that gives in when he's right is a married man. So congratulations, I love you both.
Hi, I'm Lorelai.
Hi.
The first time I saw Victoria, in the fourth grade, I didn't really see her. I just saw hair in a ponytail. And then the next time I saw her, I saw hair again, but this time it was in a braid. So I think in the fourth grade, we were all kind of wondering, is it one person, is it two? And then eventually we found out there were new cool twins at school in our grade. Victor was the one with the braid, by the way. Putting you on blast. It was a really nice braid. But anyway, it took another year for us to officially meet and become friends in Miss D's class. But ever since then, our friendship has lasted and grown through elementary, junior high, high school, college, and now to your wedding. We learned a lot together side by side in school, but one thing in particular that I've learned from you and your example is self-confidence. I've seen it carry you through the good times and bad times, kicking ass and taking names. And I've watched you grow into an even more beautiful, intelligent, confident woman. And I'm so proud of you and the future that lies ahead for the both of you. And Eddie, take care of our girl, because I know that she's already going to be taking care of you. And you remember what I told you, right?
Okay.
Okay, I'm keeping an eye on you.
Hello, my name is Shane, and I can't believe I've known you for pretty much half of my life, our lives. I was 10, you were 11, Victoria. To number the things that we've been through, we would be here till who knows when. It's too much to count. We've gone through so much, so many changes, so many chapters, so many trials we've been through, but one thing that stays constant is this. This has stayed constant. And through thick and thin, near or far, we have stayed. Victoria, I'm so proud. We are so proud of you and how far you've come. And know that everything that happens, we will be right beside you, behind you, in every situation that you're going through, just as we have these past years. Eddie, continue to take care of Victoria. Be her crutch to lean on. Be her Tylenol when she's in pain. Be her everything that she needs you to be. Whew. May God in his love be the pillar of your marriage. And congrats in everything. We love you.
Hi, everyone. I'm Linda. So just like all the other girls here, I've known Victoria for a really, really long time. One thing that has stood out to me is, as you all know, she loves basketball. So that's all she wore in elementary school, in high school. All she wore was basketball shorts. Even when we had to wear school uniforms, she never wore skirts. And she always wore pants and like shorts all the way down to her knees, and she would always, always refuse to wear, I don't know if you know this, Eddie, but she would refuse to wear a dress, even at banquet, like she would never, so yeah. But tonight, out of all of us, V, you're wearing the biggest dress out of all of us, and so, we're so happy for you. It's been so fun to watch you grow into this gorgeous, amazing, talented woman. And I'm so, so happy for you and the life that you and Eddie will be having. So congratulations. I love both of you.
Late night talks, V giving me amazing massages after practice, and me beating her in dunk contests in our dorm room, that she became my best friend. V, I'm so happy for you that you finally got your love and basketball story. Eddie, she's been smitten with you since the very beginning, and it's been amazing to watch your love story grow. I love you both, and I'm so excited for you as you guys start this new chapter of your life. So let's all raise our glasses. And guys, we love you, we support you, and let's enjoy the rest of the night celebrating you as Team Robinson.
Everybody came out. Turned out to be very, very nice. The girls, they said a lot of good things over there, but my son, you know, he liked to play basketball, and that was his thing, and I never thought he would get something out of it. So I'm really, really, really proud of him. You know, I mean, he didn't get he didn't go to college, he didn't go to, you know, pros or nothing, but he got the best thing out of the whole deal. You know, so. I'm really, really proud of him. Because Victoria, she is a beautiful woman. She's, you know, she's never said anything bad about me. I think she's the only woman that I know that hasn't said one thing bad about me. So anything she wants, anything she needs, she can get from me. There's no, hey, Candace, I'm sorry, but you know me and you, we go at it, you know. And she just, Victoria just sits back and doesn't say anything. She's just wonderful. And I'm like, wow. But I love both of my kids, and I love you, Victoria, and your family is wonderful, and I'm glad to have all of you. And wish everybody would hold your glasses up and let's do a little toast here. And to Victoria and Eddie Robinson, here, here.
Hello, okay. I'm Jordan, I'm EJ's younger cousin. Like I told him before we came into today, I'm not gonna write nothing down, so whatever I'm feeling in the moment is what I'm gonna say.
All right.
First and foremost, I wanna just say to you, not every man is ready to be married or will ever get married, and will always say they're not ready to be married. And leading into that, I've had quite a few conversations here recently where people are like, you know, you'll never know. And one day I was just sitting back with EJ here and I'm like, you know what, you do know when you're ready because the things around you will change and it'll tell you that you're ready. Something I want to mention about him, last year I was living in Kentucky and I called him up and we're just chit-chatting and he's like, yo, like we need to do something with our pops, you know, let's get together, let's do this. I was like, oh, well, we could join a bowling league, you know, I bowl. Your dad bowl, my dad bowl. I mean, you could try it. In the back of my mind, I'm like, you know, it can't be worse than a jump shot, so. No, I'm playing. Okay, look, I'm playing. Okay, so anyways, he's like, all right, let's do it. So we find this league, and we start bowling on Thursday nights. I don't know if you guys know this or not. But before the league started, about 2 months before it started, he calls me up. He's like, yo, man, you know, when you move back out here, we should get together and start practicing because I don't want to be the worst person on the team. You know? I'm like, all right, you know, I got you. A lot of people say they want to try stuff, but then when it comes down to doing it, they never do it. But I want to say you follow through with that. We would go practice 2-3 times a week, and with your work schedule, I know it was tough, like. And that shows commitment for me, you know. I don't have a lot of older, you know, people to look up to, or no one's ever perfect, you know. And I'm not perfect at all. So all my older cousins and siblings and stuff, I'm like trying to grasp, you know, what can I get from them? And this man's commitment is crazy. I'm like getting up at what, 5 o'clock to come bowl, and then have to go to work straight from there, and not get off till the next day. That's like a 13-hour commitment. You know, and that's not even counting what he's spending time with his newly wife. Yeah. So I'm like, I love that. And then I see him, how he is with his parents. And it, like the love you have for your parents is just unbelievable. Like, and for your sister, for your cousins, like whoever's around you, like you give so much love. And I've always cherished that in you. And I appreciate you for that. So in that, I want to say, you know, when the babies start coming, you know, you'll have that to teach them. You can teach them what it means to commit to someone. You know, you can teach them what it means to love someone unconditionally. Please do not teach them how to shoot. Okay. Yeah, you can call me your jazz for that. You know what I mean? We got you. No, I'm kidding, but seriously and honestly, man, I wish you guys nothing but the best. And I'll always be there for you. I'll always be around. Whether I'm living in California, I'll be there at the drop of a dime whenever you call me, you know that. And same thing for you too now, Victoria. I've been promising you a cookie date for about 2 months now, and we're gonna do that. We're gonna sit back, we're gonna bake cookies and have a great time. But at the end of the day, I just want to tell you guys that I love you guys, and I want to say thank you to you for making this step with her. And thank you to you for allowing him to fulfill his purpose as a man. So I just want to appreciate you. We're close to that. We're close to that.
So, contrary to what my little sister over here says, I am the actual twin, the original better half. So, so while you guys may look alike, there you are. I actually had to share the womb with her. I'm not had like a bad thing. Like, I think it was a pretty good time. I'd like to think we partied in there. It was back in the 90s, so my mom probably had a cassette player, bumping Earth, Wind, and Fire, just having a good time. Yeah, she said I had to dance, so I got that in there a little bit. It was just a party for us in there. And that kicking at the end was actually me, unfortunately, kicking her up into the ribs. She got stuck. I got out of there. Party was over. Which is why I'm 15 minutes earlier, and she was my younger sister. Sorry about that. So we always grew up pretty close. You know, we had the same hairstyle, as Lorelai said. She wore it better. So people always got us mixed up. We'd have the same classes in elementary school. She always got better grades because she was the smarter half. Played sports on the playground together and at home. She was the only girl in the family at that time, so she had her dollhouse, and we play action figures and dolls together. She had a basketball action figure. She made me play with the dolls. So we had a big family, so we'd always play team sports together, and we'd always be on the team. And especially for stuff like basketball, you know, she was obviously better than me. So I'd dribble around a little bit and then wait till she got open, pass to the ball, she'll score all the points. And I'll just talk trash the whole time. And then she obviously continued that into an amazing basketball player, an all-around leader on and off the court in high school and in college. And that's no doubt how Eddie got attracted to her. And they continued their relationship through basketball, and they grew, and it's been amazing to watch them as their love has gotten better through the years. When she first introduced us to him, you know, like an older brother, right? I have to be like stronger, right? So we're in the parking lot doing push-ups, trying to look big, and we're walking up to him, trying to like look all strong, shaking his hand strong. And then we couldn't keep that up for long. We probably looked really silly, but like with his humorous, genuine, charismatic personality, like it's not long before we're over there just laughing and having a good time, especially with both of them together, because they really complement each other when we're all just clowning on each other and having a great time out there. And for Eddie, like it wasn't long before he really became part of our family. I know tonight it makes it official, but he was always out there at my brother and sister's basketball games. Every time I come home, he's there for the holidays. He's got my back on Xbox Live when we're playing games. So tonight you're officially part of the family, but you've been my brother for a long time. It was only a matter of time before you guys got married. Victoria, I know I already told you this, but you look beautiful tonight. I was so excited when you guys FaceTimed me and asked me to walk you down the aisle. I told my friend about it, and she was like, "Oh, that's awesome. You get to walk your other half down the aisle." Oh, while she gets to go marry her other half. That really didn't hit me until I turned the corner out here and I see my sister looking gorgeous in her dress. I start walking her down the aisle, the doors open, and she gasped a little bit. And then I walk her down so she can marry the love of her life, and he can walk his other half down the aisle. And I couldn't be more grateful to have a person to do that like you, Eddie. Like I said, you've already shown your love for her, how you're going to cherish her and take care of my sister. And can you continue to do it long into the future? So Eddie, my brother, Victoria, my twin sister, I love you both so much. And sorry. I'm holding. If you guys ever need anything, just know that you still have this other half as well. So, like, do a toast to my brother Eddie and my twin sister Victoria.
Oh, she was wanting a hug from one of her halves. Yeah, no, we want you to cry.
I'll cry for both of them.
No, Victor was last. No, I'm just kidding, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding.
Okay. Yeah, so, I don't know. All the other siblings are up here, and I just, there's something that I need to say to Victoria and Eddie both, but I'll start with Victoria. You, ever since I was young, you've just been that role model, like the perfect, just everything. And I know that I could always talk to you and tell you what's going on and just get a good, like, a solid person who was always, like, I could look up to. And now that you're getting married to Eddie, and I'll get to you in a second, just hold on. But now that you're getting married to Eddie, I could just, like, think in my mind how bright of a future you have, just seeing you grow up from a little brother's point of view, and seeing how strong you were with Victoria, I mean, with Mary Layla, and with me, and with Victor, and with, you know, the Thad and Jonathan, too, everyone. You were always a strong centerpiece, and you're always, like, the perfect role model to look up to. I mean, you have, like, you got right into your job, you're getting married, your life is beautiful. And I'm just so happy for you because I know that even if I feel like I'm lost in my life, I can always look right up to you and you'll probably be lost, but you might just be writing your 10-page paper, going to your 12-hour shifts and working hard and handling everything that life throws at you. Eddie, and I'll tell you, when I first met you, I was like, ooh, what? Who is this? What's up? Who's this guy? What's up? But now, you know, we played basketball. He'd always give me advice, try to talk to me, get on me at Xbox Live. And eventually one day, it just clicked. It was like, you know what? This is the homie right here. This is my man now. Like, always giving me advice, always looking out for me, trying to keep me safe, trying to keep me happy, always trying to, like, pick at me for my problems and say, hey, man, if you need help, I got you. If you need this, I got you. I'm here for you. And I just want to say I appreciate that. And, you know, I'm so happy that this is like official. You're my brother now, and just congratulations because I love you guys so much. And this, I just had to cry because it was just so happy. You guys are just so cute. And I guess it's finally happening. And it's just like, oh. So yes, I love you guys. Can hold on to.
fire. I'll hold it back again. This passion inside can't run from myself. There's nowhere to hide. Your love I'll remember forever. Oh, no, make me close one more door. I don't wanna hurt anymore. Stay in my arms if you know how much I imagine you there. Don't walk away from me. I have nothing, nothing, nothing.
Tears from the stars.
And every night spent without your face has me shuddering.